we're still waiting on two people. One last person.
The Fukaren Butaren. Shirunu, if you do, he poopy. Did you click on my picture I sent everyone? It was Fanny.
Me. Me.
Who the fuck takes a selfie while driving?
Stupid people.
I want to punch people in the face who do that. That's absolutely a you earn your death.
All right, so everybody who's clicked that box, please sound off.
Sound off.
Sound off.
We're waiting on Quibor then.
That he clicked.
Nice, ready.
Okay, good. All right, so we will go ahead and begin. Like I said before, when he was not paying attention, Abla may be joining us tonight if he happens to get back and doesn't get, you know, drunk and high at his friend's house or at Tracy's house. Can't really remember which one it is. All right.
Is that a barbecue?
Or something, yeah. But, so, where we left off was, as you guys were running about the room, killing flame elementals, just for the sake of the party's knowledge, some of you are not aware that this happened, like a lot of you are not. Jason's character, Silver, basically jumped over a pit on his way chasing a flame elemental. Neely went up and inspected it, the panel slapped shut after she played with it a little bit and repaired it. And that set a mechanism in the motion. Simultaneously, Limu was chasing another one on the opposite side of the hall.
He didn't repair anything.
Okay, excuse me. He managed to get it unstuck. Point is,
all she did was look at it.
You said she manipulated it in some way, because that was the trigger for it.
Okay.
That definitely happened. Point is, regardless, touching it in some way managed to make the thing come on, managed to make the stuck part come undone. Point is, Lumu, on the opposite side of the place, this side, was chasing another flame elemental and fell into one of the holes. This one was operational. In the ensuing round, it closed and started moving around. It cut off a piece of rope and cut off another piece of rope after everybody found her again in another pit. Apparently, the only people who know that she's alive are James, Quibor, and Silver. Everybody else assumes that the worst has happened, or that they'll never see her again. Who knows? They do, however, know that the things are moving around. Neely escaped off into parts unknown. No one knows where she went. James went and stood outside. Both of these actions were performed at the behest of Desolo, who is currently being chased by a little fire elemental who keeps falling around saying, meh.
Yeah.
Also, Zig keeps falling into the damn hole and getting floated back up.
I get knocked down, but I get up again.
Alright, so I believe at the...
Yay! Why you start?
At the top of the round is where we started. We stopped, excuse me. Let me go ahead. It would normally be Deathlow's turn. Whoops, did not mean to skip. I did it skip two people. Anyways... So it would be Deslo's turn. I need James, Quibor, and Zig to roll me listen checks.
In the tower.
Yes, please. Oh, good. All three of you got this. Okay, so the three of you, all of you start hearing a faint whirring sound at the very, very, it seems to be centered on the pit. Tesla, it is currently your turn.
Alright. remind me, the four squares ahead of me were where we last thought a trapdoor might have been?
Somewhere in that general area, yes.
Okay. I would like to just watch that spot, and if I could ready a reflex to kind of dive away if I feel like it's opening up underneath me.
Okay. Are you going to be moving on top of it?
No, I'm going to stand where I am, because I'm assuming it's going to open up in the square in front of me. But just in case it moves, I'd like to ready an action to, you know, dive away.
Very well. I'm making a thing. There we go. Now we have a party split channel. I can use if I need it for something. Alright, so you're ready to sit there and do something. James, your turn. Oops, I probably should have had you do that.
Okay. I tell them to stay up in this corridor. Watch for any opening trap doors. I'm going to run back this way.
Okay.
If it'll let me map out my thing. I'm going to go that way. Not caring about the little imp there thing. Fire. And while I'm running, I'm going to tell Deslo that Silver and Quibor, along with a giant freaking bird, are up there waiting for Lumu to reappear, so she is still alive.
Okay.
And I'm going to run down that way.
Okay. When you're ready, please end your turn.
Let me open the thing. There we are. That's for the sure. One I need.
Dig. Hey, hold on. That's weird. It totally skipped a creature. This guy.
Me.
Who's currently like, wait. Hey, running past me.
Get back here, you.
I won't fight you. I won't fight.
Now's the turn. Like, totally skip that guy, even though he's there. He's just hidden.
Somebody has saw
it. Your turn.
So I'm guessing that open pit in front of me is not actually an open pit in front of me.
It is an open pit in front of you.
Oh, it is?
Yeah, no, Zig's fallen into it plenty of times, and you almost had to get him out.
Well, Luma's still on there, right?
We don't know exactly where she is.
Jeff, did you forget what happened when that pit opened?
Maybe.
I don't remember that you floated, and then the owl got you, and then it scratched Quibor.
No, the owl failed to get me, punched Quibor in the face, and I teleported out.
Oh, well, it rolled a natural one. He got you the first time, though.
Oh, yeah, that's right. It left a little bit earlier. Yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
Yeah, but he got you the first time it happened. Then the second time it happened, yeah. He rolled a natural one and accidentally hit Quibor.
Yeah, well, I guess we got to bring Quibor up to speed on what has happened since he left.
Your familiar summon thing punched you in the face.
Okay. Yeah. So basically the big thing, though, is this is a different hole than...
Yes.
Unless only we magically disappeared.
We don't know. All I know is these keep opening up in different areas, which I think James has noted where they are. At least where the ones he saw.
I did, but it kind of deleted the thing. Apparently it doesn't keep track of our little drawings on the board.
Well, I'm going to start going that way and have my Allo follow me.
All right.
That'll probably be my turn. For now.
Okay. End it when you are ready. What the fuck? It's skipping like several people.
Maybe this was the update.
Maybe. Okay, and the owl's probably gonna go. It got a speed of 70, so it'll just fly after you. Big, it has to make those wide turns.
Caw caw!
Caw caw! Lumu! Lumu is in the bottom. Oh, see, it just went one that time. That's weird. Alright, so Lumu is in the bottom of a pit. In a hole. In a hole. In a
down
hole.
In a hole. In a hole. Yeah.
Okay. So Lumu's getting impatient. She's probably going to try an accelerated climb. But, well, actually, she would know something. I need to make sure that I give her a chance to. Let's see.
Created handholds.
She is creating handholds, that's correct. Okay. She's going to be doing something else for this particular part of the realm because of something she knows is happening. Neely, you are currently in a small room. What do you do?
Is getting bored.
I imagine.
Actually, no, these are each 6 seconds, so she's probably still cleaning her nails.
Gotcha.
Waiting for someone to come get her.
You finally have a chance to do something.
Okay, Steve, does Steve hear the thing where Lumu's not dead?
I would say no. You were on the opposite side of several very thick walls from where that was spoken, which was all the way over here.
105 feet through the walls.
Through three sections of 5 feet walls of masonry.
Got it, so now.
Yeah,
all right, now Steve has no reason to do anything but stand the fuck there.
Yay!
By the way, your current effects are repelling shield and heroism.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm gonna stand the fuck there.
All right.
There are gnolls on the other side of the hallway.
I murder them all.
No. Knowles, they came there to help you. They were going to give you the benefit of the doubt, but then you murdered them.
Again.
Oh, hey, I can't see anybody else's health thing.
What do you mean?
Where's itchy?
On the combat tracker.
Can't see health?
No, oh, yeah. Nobody else's.
No.
I can see the fire elemental medium one's health. Just that's it.
See its health? That's weird.
Well, not health, just like the healthy part. Press healthy.
It's not the ones that do HP again.
But I don't see anybody else.
Yeah, I don't know.
I don't even see my own. Honest. Which, fine with me. Oh, wait, no. I actually do see wounds. And HP.
Alright. Well, Desolate, it is your turn.
Okay, I'm gonna...
Actually, wait, hold on. No, it's not your turn. I'm sorry.
I say that was fast.
It actually happens.
No.
Hey, well, the round did go by pretty quick, but the actual thing that's happening is only supposed to happen at the top of the round.
Mm.
Alright, anyways, Silver, you were actually privy to this. Deslo, you do not have line of sight, I do not believe. But you do not, so you can't see this. Silver is the only person. Silver, the panel right in front of you snaps shut, and certainly you start hearing the worry mechanisms. Everyone in general, since you're kind of aware of it, with the exception of Steve, Steve's kind of aware of it too, can generally hear the faint sound of mechanisms moving something around. Let's see. Okay.
Yeah, what's Quibor go to do?
Quibor said he was going to go look over there, I think. I don't know if he actually said that, though. You just kind of went over there.
Kind of just, yeah, probably look over there-ish.
Alright. Alright, Deslo. Now it's your turn.
Okay. I'd like to continue my ready to action, waiting to react should the trap door in front of me open.
So, just for my own benefit, are you going to attempt to keep it open, or what? Or jump out of the way of it?
Well, if it opens, if it's the four squares in front of me where I'm thinking it's going to open, I want to be ready to try and help Lumu, but if it happens to move and open up underneath where I am, I want to be able to, you know, dive out of the way.
Okay, so you need to select one of those.
Okay, well, if it opens underneath me, I want to be ready to dive out of the way.
Okay. All right. Go ahead and end your turn when you're ready.
And actually, I'm going to do that. And can I also send all of my equipment into my ring so that I'll be a little bit more nimble?
Sure, you can do that.
Okay. I will do that and then end my turn.
Alright, and just for what's worth, whenever you send your equipment into your ring, deduct your armor, and on your inventory sheet there, there's that armor checkbox there, you can just unequip it. What that'll do is it will release you from the skill check penalty and the max stat penalty, which I have unclicked it now. But
okay.
So you know.
So do I need to do anything else?
No. Okay. By the way, is your tower shield gone now?
Yes, it's in the ring as well.
Alright, then I will inactivate your tower shield penalty.
Alright.
Alright, you're ready. James, it is now your turn.
Alright, I'm gonna continue running over here. Dang it! Why?
Over here. No, over here. Over here.
Not there, there.
Right there.
There you go. You are running.
And the trap door opens. Running.
I'm hustling.
No. Actually, he's just kind of, well, you're, you double, well, I guess you kind of hustle, yeah. Okay, so you're hustling. You're hustling.
A cheetah
and,
fast.
I'm going to sit there, that, and I'm going to look left and right, left, right, left and right, left and right, waiting for the things to trigger.
All right, just go ahead and pass your turn when you're ready. It's this guy's turn. He's like, oh, that guy ran away. Go back to visiting.
Like, yeah.
He's like, meh.
That poor little guy.
He still hits me.
Because you don't have your armor up.
Yeah. Yeah, true.
Teslo, need your reflex save.
Reflex save.
Was not to burst in the flames.
Not entirely sure why we haven't killed it yet, since it's probably new what we need to do to open these doors.
We don't know. Because that guy told us not to.
Who told us not to?
Silver.
Silver. He said, right, don't kill
you
it.
You saved just as well, so you don't
have to. Yeah, I'm pretty sure he said he wanted to capture it.
He did. He's starting to piss me off.
He wanted to, like, kill it with ice magic or. Or, like, if
I wasn't
killed
kill
it,
one
it would
to
open
kill
all the
ice
doors
magic.
And then something would come out.
He did, but it's starting to piss me off.
Possibility. I stabbed the ground in front of me with my glaive.
You stabbed the ground in front of you with your glaive. The ground chips just a bit.
Does it open or anything?
Does not.
Okay.
Feels pretty solid. Five more. Good turn.
Yep.
You hear the sound of a small chink behind you. If someone just hit something really hard.
Alright. Unbearable faggot.
Of course.
How else have you heard that one?
Suddenly you hear a voice descend from above. Unbearable faggots. Turns out it's Hellion.
That's something he would say.
So I was wondering, could I move while using my quarterstaff, kind of like, you know, like touching it forward to see if I can activate the thing in front of me?
Yeah, you can do that.
Okay, do you want me?
You will have to still roll a search penalty, but I'll rule that it'll probably be really easy, considering that you're doing that. At least it will affect anything ahead of you. So, to move at half speed while doing it.
Okay.
Actually, yeah, forget the search penalty, just do it at half speed. Because you're taking the time to go really slow while being ahead of you.
Okay, so if I hit anything there, otherwise.
Okay. Alright, with this movement, you press and prod against the ground as you're moving ahead, very, very slowly, very carefully. You don't manage to find anything, which is really, really good news to you. I will say, as you stop, however, you do notice this little area that you haven't been to before. One of these cabinets is thrown open, the other one is closed.
Alright. Were all both cabinets closed?
It is,
both
Wonder.
I don't remember. Owl's turn.
Is it Lim's turn? It's supposed to be Owl's turn. I don't understand why it keeps skipping people. I mean, I got to fix the other one. It's just now the owl. The owl, I assume, is still following you because you have not given it a different command. Okay.
Yep, still following. It falls in the hole. Wow.
It does not. Limu! Limu, the opportunity has come. We'll start making certain actions to see if she can free herself because she's getting fucking impatient. Let's see. Right, another one. Deslo, do me a favor, throw a listen in the tower.
Alright.
Deslo, somewhere just ahead of you somewhere, you hear the faint sounds of scratching and then a loud thud. Neely, what are you doing there in the room by yourself?
Ending her turn.
All by my...
Steve, you hear very, very small prods on the ground behind you, little tappings on the stone. If you were to turn around behind and look, see behind you through the open door, you would probably see Bybor very carefully tapping the area ahead of him as he moves.
I'll see a giant fucking owl.
What the hell he's doing?
Searching for the Pit of Doom!
Be fair, you do know that the pit exists, Steve. You fell in one before.
Yeah.
I'm gonna step in here. Board. Let's use some more of it,
Boy. Okay.
Probably gonna set up a trap and die.
Steve, I need you to make a reflex save.
Good job.
Shit.
It was coming. Save the fuck I was. Gonna roll a one.
Let's see, what is the DC on that?
Two.
Oh no, it's you did not meet that at all.
Oh god. Damn it.
As you're walking, Steve, you know, kind of like, what the fuck are you doing, Gwebor? You suddenly, you know, on the floor, the panel just goes out from underneath you. It just slides into the floor like, whoosh, and down you go. You try to dodge out the way, but you're unfortunately caught unawares, and you go into the pit.
Once again,
is there anything
you door out of it? This is a big deal.
That's true. Do you have anything you can do to stop your fall? It does surprise you, so you can't use a standard action, but you can. Okay, so you have nothing. All right. Well then, you take 5d6 points of damage.
It seems like everyone's gonna end up slowly dying from falls.
Oh wow, that was almost max damage. You have 27 out of 30 damage done to you.
Ouch.
Steve, I need you to make a fort save. Or will save.
Not
much... or sire.
Wow, this is going to be like worst case scenario. Great.
Right? Put your door. I
will be like, Steve, stop pretending to be Dustlock.
Or will, right?
or will.
Oh, will.
Is Larry down there?
Yeah, you got out of the five sixes you rolled, you had sixes and three fives. Almost max damage.
Anyways.
Let's see, what is your hap point here? You stay up. You hit the ground and you feel like part of you just cracked. The entire bottom half of you just like is in shambles on the inside. You're very, very in pain. Very, very much.
He screams loudly and ends his turn.
Alright. Fribor, you get to see all of this except for the part where he actually hits the ground.
Neat.
Eslo.
You seem to hear the screaming of pain, though.
You absolutely hear it. I would also rule that James hears it. Deslo, Zig, and anyone else on that side at this point is just Deslo and Zig. You have to roll listen checks.
Does Neely hear it?
You would like to have a chance of seeing what's happening. Neely probably hears it.
Okay.
Neely looks up and then goes back to filing completely... her fingernails.
Deslo and Zig, you are both completely unaware that anything has happened. You're just going about your own business.
Good, everything's okay.
In Deslo's case, he's getting whipped by a flaming beast.
So, would I hear
Deslo
say that he thinks he hears the move?
He did shout. However, he's a little bit further than you, from you than the others are. Go ahead and roll me a listen check. It'll be a fairly low DC, though, because he is shouting. So as long as you don't roll a 1 or something, you should be okay. Oh, yeah. No, you totally hear that.
Okay. Sorry, Zig, but Deslo is tired of getting hit by this fucking thing.
Real quick, before you do that, Deslo, you and Quibor need to roll listen checks.
Thought I did. Another one?
At one point, I'm just... it's for a different reason. Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Sorry.
No, it's okay.
Yeah, I can kind of understand you wanting to kill me now.
I'm tired of getting slowly burned.
Okay. Deslo. So you hear a faint whirring sound start to spin up. As Quibor, you do not. All right, Deslo, it's totally up to you. I believe all your armor is earring, though, so you'll need to make that command. Get your stuff back, unless you put your sword elsewhere.
Okay, I will command my sword.
Does your ring store armor for ring weapons? Okay. I think it literally switches the entire thing. At least in this case, might be the better option, anyways. Would you like to just go ahead and switch all your stuff?
Yes.
Okay.
That's fine.
Because the option just says it switches everything you're currently wearing in there. Okay. But maybe that's the key to this. Let me read this.
Why am I picturing Deslo like?
Okay. Yeah. So anything you're wearing. So you still have your sword. You can just hit it with your sword if you want to. You still have your sword.
Okay. I'm good with that. Time to smash
a bit. Right? Pictures Deslo kind of like Sailor Moon when he activates his ring. Like, it's just a flag around him.
Blah.
The power we should all the get those rings.
Punish you. Almost critted. But you did damage, so go
but
ahead
I can't
roll.
Crit anyway. Blah.
That's true. This guy isn't crittable.
Blah.
He's like, ow. Like, meh.
Blah.
Nine.
Damn it. Alright. And that would end my turn.
Got him pretty hard. First one. Alright. Your turn.
Did my click thing work?
It did. It did. It's now James' turn.
Yay.
Do I go to try to help Lumu or Steve?
Did you hear Steve?
Yes.
Yep.
I heard.
He also heard Deslo say that he thinks Lumu's over there.
Yeah.
You know Steve can teleport, so.
But he also Steve also cried out in a tremendous bout of agony.
He doesn't know how badly you were hurt.
Which means.
He's conscious.
He's alive.
He's conscious. He can cast a spell. He doesn't have to move his hands for the spell, does he? If his arms are broken, is that a thing?
I don't know. Maybe. I haven't actually looked at it if it requires somatic movements, but I don't think he needs actually like.
James screams out.
He has his arms broken.
Asshole, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. Fuck you.
You too.
I'm pretty sure you're not fine if your health has anything to say about it.
I don't know if Steve being face down in the dirt, this is proper roleplaying.
Fuck you too.
Why is it not working?
You just got stabbed through by... You're like, Tessari, just... Okay, Tessari, you just got stabbed right through your arm with a rapier. Ouch.
In my tongue. I go over there.
I don't like to scream unless I absolutely have to. Say,
do you understand?
Sorry, go ahead.
I go over there, I asked Eslo, where did you hear?
Do I know it was ahead of me? Yeah, I think I did.
Yes, you do. You rolled a 20. You would know.
Do I know kind of exactly?
You did roll a 20. Go ahead and put a 1 in your listen.
Yay. Doing it. Could I gesture to
you? You pinpointed it.
Okay. Okay. Desolo, yeah, like, gestures to the.
I thought we'd ruled that the perception checks, we weren't going to put ones anymore.
Okay, cool.
That is true. Yeah, don't do that.
Aw. God damn it, Jimbo.
I had forgotten. Because the perception checks will. Maybe.
Okay. Desolo would gesture to this area and say, here. I heard her here.
He says, cool, and ends his turn. With a trap card.
This is... Zig's turn!
I'm guessing Zig heard this one.
Well, you should have heard me the first time, yeah? I shouted.
Yes, you did. He's right over there.
Yep.
He definitely should.
But you didn't see me gesture. But I didn't say
your idea there in front of the door, so.
Yeah.
Because everyone I've seen has been in front of a door.
Okay. Move up to that spot there.
I try tapping the ground to get the door thing to activate.
The door does indeed activate. And, despite the fact that Lumu for some reason is hidden. Oh no, she's in because she is in there. She's rubbing her ass like she just fell from a climb.
I just kind of look down there. Hey again. Yep. Can I try jamming my weapon into the can I try jamming my weapon into the closes?
Sure, although I would have you roll a wisdom check.
Yep.
That can have very serious consequences for you if you don't play it right.
Well,
I imagine my animation is stronger than the stone.
It breaks your weapon, and it falls down and stabs through the
window. All right. Well, managed to come through that. You're worried that maybe the adamantine might not hold up against the trap door, but yeah, it might happen. We'll see.
Hmm.
And again, you are correct. Adamantine is stronger than regular stone. Hey, there he is.
Diablo!
Yay!
Diablo! We found you!
Yay.
Good timing. We found you, and you're here.
Can we see any mechanisms?
I just got home, so I'm gonna be on in just a little couple minutes. I just got used to the bathroom, so just feel free to continue, and I'll be there shortly.
Can I see any of these things' mechanisms since we could hear them?
No, you cannot. This is a very masterfully designed thing. It just panel just slides into the floor.
I hate this masterfully designed thing.
You keep hearing them, but you can't see them. It is a masterfully designed thing.
Masterfully.
I'm sorry, what'd you say?
I hate this thing.
I think by now we all hate this thing.
Well, you're in the Tower of the End Times. I like how this trap is slowly you guys. It's just...
Has no any damage to me.
It's an inanimate creature. Maybe a creature. It's, yeah. Has no any damage to you because you actually have a thing that keeps you from getting damaged, but... It's just slowly... around. murdering people. To be fair, Lumu hasn't actually taken a whole lot of damage from it, but Eve just took a bunch of damage because he managed to get an almost maxed out roll of damage, and he's particularly squishy.
I guess I'll just end my turn for now.
Alright, but was... Alright, not doing anything with the trip pit then?
No, my character's worried about it. I'm kind of worried about it myself. Because adamantium may be stronger than regular stone, but it's kind of a magical tower. So...
Obviously.
It's your turn. You just saw Steve's feet go out from under him and he went into a hole. He was accompanied by the sound of many, many cracks of bone.
Fortunately, my character can't. Whoops. God damn it. My character can't do a whole lot about that. But he'll just tell the owl to walk up to the hole, look down. See the hump that is Law, that is Steve, and he'll tell the owl to go fetch him.
Alright.
I don't think I can really do anything else, so...
Let's see.
Yep.
Owl has 70 feet. Let's see, this is 20 feet, and owls cannot fly straight down, so I guess it'll just kind of dive. At which point, it manages to land beside Steve, starts picking him up.
Better not drop me, because if it drops me, I'm gonna die.
You're not gonna die.
Yes, I am.
Balumu kind of looks up and sees that light has entered the hole she's in. And in a bit of like, kind of like a really pissed off, angry face, she just starts like fucking climbing up to the top as fast as she possibly can. She's tired of being in this goddamn hole.
Out of the hole!
What were they chanting in
She starts the Dark Knight? Some really good distance. You can. What?
Were they chanting when people were climbing out of the pit in the Dark Knight?
She's climbing up on the side. I'm on her back up.
Good distance. Well, hold on, guys. So she starts climbing up. She gets about maybe 20, 30, 40 feet up into the air, and she's almost at the top, but then she like makes a I say almost, it's very relative. She's about a couple links down. anyways, she gets pretty close, and then she like just makes a completely wrong move. She loses grip on her primary hand, then the rest of it just follows afterwards, and she's back down.
God damn it!
Thankfully, however, she probably curses a lot. She does display a good bit of aerodynamics and just starts to try and lessen her fall damage, and she succeeds. Only taking, let's see, where's the dice?
But you become one of those gliding squirrels or something?
gliding cow lady.
No, she just starts rolling in the air. When she hits the ground, she kind of like just absorbs it by rolling a bit.
Rolling down the wall.
let's see. Alright. He does look like she took a little bit of damage, though, like, as evidenced by her loud, FUCK! As she hits the ground. Anyways, Neely's turn. Bullshit. Neely, what are you doing?
Does Neely hear any of this commotion out here?
Neely pops out of the closet.
She doesn't hear that part.
Neely pops out of the closet, looks over. And you can probably see Quivor, right?
Yes.
Maybe. Yeah. She goes, yep. Hey, Puddles, what's going on?
Everybody dying.
Steve fell down this pit. Again.
Okay.
Well, I'm not sure if I know again, but he fell down this pit. It looks like a humbug.
To be fair,
can you get out?
No, but it is the... You...
Neely would know it happened again.
Yeah. He just asked you if he can get out, by the way.
Steve?
Yeah.
I don't know.
No.
Somebody owl down
Neely,
there.
Yeah, there you go. Sorry.
Hopefully the owl should get him back up before the thing closes
heroes,
again.
You know that?
Ain't we just...
Ain't we just
I'm just saying, it's like, hey, can you get out? I don't know.
Well, there's nothing she can really do. He has...
No, I'm just laughing, because it's like, some of you guys just fell in a hole, and it's, I don't know, I just put the owl down there, you know, no concern, no anything. Just a, this is just all a walk in the park for you guys. All right, so Steve's
going to the fuck out of here.
What about the owl?
Fuck the owl. The owl's going to drop me and I'm going to die. No, I'm going to put the door out.
All right, guess your dimension door. You'll pop right up here.
Yeah, I do that. I can't use it this turn, but I go ahead and get my wand of healing. Wait, there's a healer right there.
I imagine you're prone.
I guess. I stand up before I do that, I guess. I don't know. Fuck it, I cast it prone. Fuck it.
Your turn when you're ready.
I yell to Quagmire, heal me, God. Oh,
wait, no, you can't. You can't. No. Wanding, wand is a standard, I believe.
Yeah, that's why I said your standard was dimension right there. So I asked the healer for healing.
All right.
You left my owl down there?
Alright, so Disla, before your turn begins, the whirring that has been going on for the entire round culminates in, again, the thing snapping shut.
My owl!
Alright.
No. Now the owl is stuck in one of the pits. And Lufus also goes shut again. Disla.
It's a glow in the dark owl.
Dislo, I know you were ready for this, but then you started attacking that thing. So unfortunately, your time to shine come to an end. I'm joking. So anyways, Dislo, and Zig, both of you, Dislo particularly while he's fighting this fire elemental, while also pointing to other people, the trap door suddenly snaps shut. Zig sits there and watches it with some interest, I assume. Lumu gets pissed off and says, not again, and... it happens. Let's see. Where does it go? I see. Very interesting.
Okay, so there's gotta be a mechanism to make this shit stop.
There does.
Maybe it's inside these rooms. You know.
Maybe.
I need to kill a fire elemental to get into.
I've tried. He's been a dick.
Try harder.
I love the way you said that too. Try harder.
Disla, your turn.
Alright. So, what I know from past experiences, this thing's about to move. In that case.
I mean, you heard the whirring. You heard the whirring from previous cases too, so. I assume what you could gather is the whirring may signal that it's moving.
Okay.
Soon, I guess.
Do I need, would I need to roll anything to know that? To know that, you know, it's going to move.
Something and you could probably infer since you've seen it a couple times.
Okay. Well, since I've seen it move, then I'm just going to attack this guy. Fuck this. Done. You're gonna, nah, you never should have come here. Now you're gonna pay. Okay, poof.
Ding. Ding gets
now we're all gonna die.
It burns out into an ember, and it turns into a small, tiny orb, and just starts floating off in some direction. Kind of goes around you.
Let's see what happens now.
We're gonna die.
Wait, it only goes about this fast. Alright. Dislo, if you got anything else you're doing? What was a standard action?
Is readying an action standard?
Yes, it is.
Okay. But drawing, that would be two actions. Alright. What I'm gonna do is if I happen to believe that these four squares are going to open again, I would like to ready the action to draw my Wand of Knock and go ahead and open it before it opens on its own.
So for what's worth, I will say this. You should have seen pretty easily Zig did before. He just tapped the floor.
Oh.
So that would lead you to believe, rather, that it's not locked. It's just a triggered mechanism.
Okay.
Weight triggered.
Well, in that case, I would ready the action to tap on it, should I hear this area, you know, sound like Lumu's here again.
All right. Fair enough. Just go ahead and pass your turn.
Okay.
James, your turn. James, you saw the trapdoor snap shut, and you assume it moved again. Rather, you are free to assume it did move again.
He says, shit. Runs back down this way.
We're getting our exercise in this round.
Damn it.
James, roll a reflex save.
Oh, fuck me.
No, I'm good with these.
Famous last words.
Yeah. Oh, shit.
James, as you run forward, you step on a thing and the floor swings open, but you manage to catch yourself with one arm, your claw hand, digging into the wall and keeping yourself hanging over a pit that seems to have a large white owl in it just staring up at you. Like, what's going on? They just get this out of the damn way because you can't fucking organize these things. I hate that.
Obviously, the white owl just has that head looking up at the head, like, upside down.
James uses his free hand and goes, hey, you know, there's a white owl in this kinda hole.
The owl just kind of ruffles.
Owl's in a hole.
That's what he screams to Eslo and Silver, by the way. There's a white owl in this hole.
You had a move action interrupted, but expended, and you still have a move action.
I'm gonna move right there. That way on my next turn I can run and jump over this thing.
Alright. Fair enough. End your turn when you're ready. Although it may seem like you got a double turn, that's because these things do. They get a turn when they die and when they get their actual turn. This thing starts floating away. Right, Zig.
I remove. Yeah. I don't shoot that thing of an ice ray.
Okie dokie.
Ray of Frost does it. I've even dropped the dice on it.
Yeah, it's pretty tiny. Woodsworth, it is in the combat tracker, so you can roll it there if you need to.
Yeah, that was what I was just about to do.
Looks like he hit it. Well, it's more dead. However, it does not seem to slow down in its attempts to move away from you.
It's more dead.
Darn it. Told me I'd extinguish it.
Alright, that was a movement and a cast. Go ahead and roll your, or end your turn, or do anything else you're planning on doing.
Can I try tapping there real quick?
No, you cannot. That would be a standard action.
I was hoping it would be a free action since I was just tapping it.
No. You just spent most of your turn sitting there making hand gestures and casting a spell and also moving.
Okay.
Alright, Quibor. Steve's laying on the ground, bleeding, with probably some bone protrusions from his belly area.
I walk over there.
Sounds like I missed something interesting.
You did.
Yeah, he got almost maxed out damage on the whole fall. He got three fives and two sixes. That's 27 out of 30 damage.
Yeah.
And that was almost all of his health. He almost died.
Yeah, he's in a bad way.
I feel the powers of the heels.
I have 12 points left.
Heal the power of the heels.
Okay, as you press your hand to his abdomen, you know, the bones start to recede back into his flesh, I guess. You know, getting back into their proper place and
my shape. Spine uncompresses.
Yeah, his back no longer looks like an S. But
I am an adult.
All right.
So yeah, that's my turn. My wolf, I was gonna fly out, bursting out of the air, all white and shit.
Sure. Go ahead and interturn there.
Skips to Limer again.
Why does it skip him? I don't know why. That's probably something they did here. Let me check something real quick, because I believe because he is flying, he can't fly straight up. So he might be in kind of a shitty position. Characters can't fly straight up, but they can kind of dive, but that kind of just involves them falling, really. Unless it has hover. Let me check the thing here. If it has hover, that means it could just float down, I guess, but well, that doesn't matter now. In this particular situation, it can't get back up.
Is there room for it to zigzag a bit?
No, it's about the size of the pit. give or take. I mean, it's Lumu's not actually the size of the pit, but, you know, it's four squares, and he's four squares, and the pit's four squares. AJ, you seem to be pretty full up on your maneuverabilities. What is average maneuverability's ability to go up at?
I may say. Mm-hmm. Let's see. Up angle 60%. I mean 60 degrees.
I see. So it can kind of get a little bit on that. Not 90, but it's
I'm assuming like flapping his wings and he's kind of like climbing up while whatevering. I don't know.
Well, if that's the case, it would be falling down all day because it has no climb skill. So what we're going to do is it's probably going to have to it's going to have to be like kind of trying to circle its way up. The only problem with that is it's going to be moving at half speed to do it because it doesn't have room to maneuver. So it gets about halfway up and it's still flying up.
Yep.
Limu, it is your turn. You are in darkness.
Yeah. So has anything really happened since I last punched a hole in the thing to start climbing up?
You got pissed off, and the second the hatch opened, you tried to rush for it, but then Lumu and Zig appeared. Zig and Deslo appeared at the top, and you just kind of lost focus and fell, I guess. You didn't take too much damage. You managed to pretty decently do a tumble, and you weren't that far up to begin with.
Yeah. All right. Well, I'm going to go back to that plan of creating handholds for myself, so however I would do that.
Okay. We'll just say you spend the time doing that this round, I guess.
Okay. I don't have a map or anything, but I've kind of figured
that's right.
It didn't. It'd be fun to see other people wandering around.
Even better. We shouldn't let you see it. Can't see any of
that. Yeah.
But, no, it's fine. It's fine. You've gotten handholds going up about maybe 20 feet or so now, just from the time you've been spending doing it, because I've also been having you do it when you were in darkness.
Sure.
All right. Go ahead and end your turn when you're ready. Ely, it's your turn. See Quibor go over and kind of, well, you don't really see Steve, I guess.
Even so Lumu is pounding away at the wall, if that, if people can hear that or anything, but.
Well, you're pretty far down there. You've gotten up 20 feet or so, but still, the nearest people to you would not be able to hear it.
Okay.
Let's see. Neely, you kind of see Quibor walk out of sight. He goes, he mentioned he's going over there to help Steve, because Steve is sitting there saying, help me! Well, probably also coughing up blood all dramatically. But instead, he's like, nah, bro, that's cool.
Such a drama queen when you're coughing up blood in your cracked space.
Except that you're not a drama queen. You say, ah, dude, hey, help me.
She leans against the inside of the cabinet, starts cleaning her fingernails again, and as you two might want to stay, steer clear from the trap door.
Yeah, thanks.
And ends her turn.
Thanks for that advice. That's great. Good advice.
All
right. Damn right.
You've been healed, and you're currently laying on the ground.
He fireballs Neely.
Okay. Roll your attack check.
It's not fireball Neely. Steve goes, well, this is some bullshit. Have we tried opening these doors?
The doors have 4 lights out of 5 lit up on them now. The 5th one is not yet lit up.
Anybody tried opening them without the lights?
They have, but they can't seem to, I believe. I'm not sure. I remember both James and Fibor examining them extensively. The doors do not seem to open.
I'm gonna grab my wand of cure white wounds out. Cure white wounds? Cure white wounds.
Lucky you're black. Or rather Arabic, I guess, but no.
As cure light wounds, I am going to cure some light wounds.
Alright.
That, I'll let you roll that because I can't have.
Wait, light wounds is only 1 dice, right? Yeah. I rolled 3 for some. You got about 7 out of that one.
And, five, that's right? It for that.
Your turn when you are ready. Alright. Let's see. Who is in the radius?
You didn't adjust my wounds, did you?
I did not adjust your health, no. You healed 7.
Thank you.
Alright, let's see. Lumu, you can hear this without a problem. James and Neely, I believe, are the only ones close enough to roll listen checks. Both of you, please do.
So, me and me.
Yes. James, you are the only one who hears this besides Lumu. Or rather, yours is slightly different. You hear the faint whirring of mechanisms somewhere nearby. Probably from that pit you saw the owl in. Lumu, you clearly hear it. All around you.
They're about to move again. Yells to Deslo and what's his name? The guy with 20 names.
All right. Deslo, it is currently your turn.
All right. The man with all the names.
It's about to move again. Okay. You know, I'm just going to... If I could, I would like to keep my ready to action to tap these 4 squares should I hear it coming to this area again. I'm just going to keep watch on this area. Be ready to tap it open.
You're very well. You're very able to do that.
Okay.
Okay. James, it's now your turn.
Oh. I run towards the hole, and I jump.
Okay. Go ahead and make your jump check.
Oh dear God, please let me make it.
I'm almost certain that is going to make it, but just for shits and giggles, let me check my...
I fell out of 1.
The DC here.
It's a 10-foot gap, so at least 11.
Yeah, no, so you beat it. Hey, hold on. I just noticed something. Are you supposed to have 148 points spent in your skill tree?
I'm pretty sure I am. I am a rogue. Slash. Dread pirate and swashbuckler.
I guess so.
Huh. I'm a skill monkey.
I suppose
I also
so.
I also have good intelligence.
Okay, yeah, sure enough. Yeah, so you do manage to make it past. Go ahead and move the rest of your movement.
And that's Sparks, he's gonna make it.
Very well. I'm leaping over the pit. Go ahead and end your turn when you're ready. A little glowing ball of light goes woo.
He goes meh.
Moves over to this door. Unbeknownst to most, who are all like busy dealing with Jimbo and his death or near death experience, and Lily, who is currently dealing with her nails, it slowly disappears into that door. Quibor.
Yes.
You actually, Quibor, Desilo, and maybe James, if he's paying attention, all of you are within clear sight of a door and close enough to actually see the front of the door, whereas Zig would have to be looking kind of at the wall here-ish. All of you suddenly see, like, the last little light on all of the doors suddenly light up. Nothing's happening yet. In the next round or so, they are very slowly lighting up. But it does signify that something may be happening soon. At least all of you. Silver, your turn.
I tap the ground in front of me. Right there.
Nothing happens. The ground is very, very, very solid. You manage to chip away some of the stone.
I move forward and tap on ground right here.
Okay, so these are standard actions, but I'll go ahead and let you do it. Because it's within the same 10-foot radius, and you can generally search a 10-foot radius. Diameter. It also dips a little bit of the stone, and nothing else happens.
Okay. And my turn.
All right. Quibor.
All right. Well, Steve looks fine, so... Yes, I'll just keep going on this way. Tapping my thing.
Okay.
Maybe, like, tap on Steve just in case.
Yeah.
Really hard.
As hard you nudging. Tap Steve, you trigger a trap. He probably punches you. Okay.
He fireballs you.
Steve basically, Steve and Quibor. Quibor basically stands up and he starts kind of moving around. In the area ahead of him very slowly and very carefully, checking the entire area as he moves ahead. Nothing seems to happen.
Exciting. That ends my turn then.
Okay. Turn, please. Again, skipping the owl for some reason. Again, me grabbing the damn map instead of grabbing the combat tracker. Alright. The owl finally manages to get out of the hole. Just in time, I assume. He kind of comes out here and goes, cuckoo!
Cuckoo! Cuckoo!
Cucking. Alright.
Dookie, dookie, caca, caca!
Limu, you're in darkness.
I think I had my gauntlet ignited.
Sure. And you're not in darkness anymore.
Okay. So, I'd like to sort of work on a handhold, but I also kind of recognize that the thing's going to move soon, so I'd like to drop down before it basically throws me down. Do I have time to do both?
You climb at normally at quarter speed. What is your speed for one round?
40.
a quarter, that would be 10. Do not right. have time to do both. Unless you do accelerate it, in which case you have a chance of falling.
Well,
I'm assuming you're taking 10, which still assumes you roll you move that quarter.
Yeah, I guess I'll just drop down for now because I got a lot of damage and I really have no clue when I'll actually get out.
All right. Okay, go ahead and end your turn when you're ready. You are now at the bottom of the pit. Healy, it's your turn.
I'm moving the wrong thing.
Sure.
She moves right there and leans against the wall. Ends her turn.
Alright, end your turn, please. Steve, it's now your turn.
She has no idea what's going on.
Steve, you're holding your wand and you were laying down.
She stands up.
Ascending?
I follow Quibor slowly. Notice that Quibor is tapping the ground, so I'll follow him because he can pass.
Alright.
Ask him what he sees in the doors. Wait, the doors aren't done yet.
No, but they will be soon.
Do I have enough action left to heal myself one more time?
You do not. You stood and you moved. Turn. All right. And your turn to the combat trigger, please. There you go. All right. Top of the round. So, the wearing mechanism spins up and gets to Aurora and starts moving again. Where it goes.
Nobody knows.
Really doesn't. I'm rolling a D% to get it. All right, oh, that's kind of shit. Oh, man. Okay. Wow, so everybody, Zig, you roll the reflex. You don't have to roll reflex saves, never mind, but you should probably still roll one to stay out of the pit. And Steve and Quibor.
I knew one was going to end up on them too.
I figured it was happen to me.
I'm sorry, it what? Is. Be fair, like, well, that'll come afterwards, but Lumi's in that one.
Be fair.
I try to catch.
Neely them. Did tell them that they might want to get off of it.
Well, they did move. They moved, but. Oh, well, okay. Zig, the only person who doesn't need to avoid the thing, manages to avoid it as it opens. The other two rolled a 9 and a 19, respectively, which are not enough on either call. So, immediately, down to the hole they go, and Limu is there. Limu, would you like to try to catch them?
Yeah.
Roll an attack roll on each of them, and subtract minus 10 from it.
Okay. What's plus?
He hits the ground.
Catch the baby. Boop.
Quite where's the ground. You tried your best.
Another one. Crazy.
Yeah. Well, they did just suddenly fall on top of you.
It's not like a touch attack.
It's true. Touch attack's probably better. But you wouldn't. I don't think you would have caught Steve with a touch attack. His base is 10.
Yeah. No, I hear you.
So Quibor and Steve, you guys, as you're walking, or you know, you're catching everything in front of you. You're trying to, you know, keep an eye on stuff, but that doesn't account for something suddenly moving underneath you. Unfortunately. The trapdoor suddenly opens up, And both of you find yourselves on top of it. You both give each other a very comical if, and you believe this fucking stare at each other, and then you both fall. Do you have anything you can do to not fall down? This is a surprise, so you can't cast spells, but do you have any movements you can do?
Nope.
Are you trained in tumble, either of you?
Pretty sure I'm not.
Very unfortunate.
Oh yeah, no, definitely not.
Alright. Then 5d6.
It'd be pretty surprising if you guys were trained in tumble.
Looks like Steve takes 22 damage. Not as bad as it was before, but it's a lot. 34.
No, four with that one.
You do, but it's going to be pretty easy. You can do four or will. And Quibor. Oops. My dice. Yeah, you stay up easy on that one. And Quibor, you take 17. So that is 23, I think. Okay. Now, clearly, you guys, Lumu tries to catch you guys. You see this, and you're kind of hoping for it. But unfortunately, you slip past her, and it's just like black on the ground. But you're in good company, because Lumu is down here with you. Yay! Maybe y'all can all figure a way out.
I can dimension door three people, can't I?
I don't know. I'm just going to set that there, because it's a fucking pain to manipulate that fucking image.
I want to do it again. Oh my
you
God,
understand that the pit is right there, right? In fact, I'm just going to do this. It's easier. It's right there. I'll put the bit back when you're out of it, if y'all are. All right. Dig, you're out of the way. It is Deslo's turn, finally. Deslo, you are naked, holding your sword.
Yep.
Well, maybe you have your underclothes on. You have your Under Armour on.
I can bring one additional creature.
It must be very, very cramped in that hole.
A little cramped.
Okay.
I guess you can flood yourself out, right?
Yep, I'm good. If you ask, my character will say, yeah, he's fine.
Do I know that this opened?
Get out.
Let's see. Out, can't you? If you can see it from any corner of your square.
Oh, I can't blow you out. I can only use that once
a
day.
Not from that one, but let's see if you can see it from...
Well, I can get myself out. You can
see the very, very faintest openings of a pit right there from that angle.
All right. I'm naked now, so it is...
You did kind of see Zig just jump back a bit, too.
Let's see. What is my speed now that I'm naked?
30.
Well,
it should be 30, yes.
Okay. Alright. I'm going to head that way. That's going to be all I have.
You look in the pit. There's nothing there.
There's nothing there.
You do notice something over. These doors are all lit up, and they all seem to be glowing. In fact, everybody notices that, with the exception of these three down here. You notice it, James. Neely notices it. You two notice it. All the doors seem to be glowing right now. James, your turn. You just saw Quibor and Steve disappear into a pit after coming around the corner.
And... pretty sure Steve can get them out of there.
Paul didn't kill him.
So
you did hear two resounding thuds as they fell.
True. He screams out, "Hey, Quibor, y'all alive down there?"
Oh, my name! Yeah, right. Keep laying
flat
on his
face. Get the fuck off my head, Lumu. Okay,
y'all got Lumu down there. Cool, I'm gonna check out this door. And he goes over to the door and tries to open it.
Okay.
Yeah, we are a bunch of heroes, aren't we?
Yeah, right? Exactly, that's what I'm saying. You guys hero-ness. You are, like, not heroes at all. Okay, so anyways, as you press your hand to the door, kind of like almost if you were trying to open it or something, or push it open or something, it just kind of opens.
And you are attacked by everything.
In fact, all of them do.
Bwah, bwah, bwah.
Neely, you are suddenly surprised by the fact that two doors on each side of you just suddenly opened. Teslo, you guys see across the pit something go whoosh, and the door opens. You also hear the faintest impressions that something happened behind you as well. What
Neely goes, this is so James is doing.
Okay, and what you guys see, I mean, you're going to have to kind of get your own little ideas as to what your actual lines are, your cone of vision, given that there is no actual vision blocking. But what you see is this.
Hmm.
And for some reason, one hidden pillar that is not there. There you go.
That looks bad.
Hey, there's God. A pyramid in this
Could
room.
It be? Could the tower actually be the black materia? Are we gonna get a comet?
No, suddenly just this pyramid is
he murders Quibor and then flies away before Lumu and, you know, he can do anything.
I think Sephiroth is
like Eric. I don't
know any of this shit.
I still feel like Sephiroth would just kill everyone.
They wouldn't. He would sit around to Maki a little bit, and then maybe he'd let yeah. Genova, he'd let Genova do it for him.
He would kill our best killer and then leave.
Right? He's not metrosexual. At least, actually, I take that back. You have no idea what his sexuality is. It's never hinted at.
True.
Who do Mustafa well,
leave? We'd kill our best healer and then leave. Oh. Quapor, sorry, be gone.
No, come on. We need him.
And then we would have to leave you in a puddle of water. So you would become with the water, I guess?
You know, actually, I take that back. I do know he does have a slight hint that he has an Oedipus complex. Although I don't know if that's just because he's freaky or what. These guys are going, mother.
Yeah, all right, he's a mama sexual.
I took a 5-foot step and used a move action to open that.
Oh, man. You can open doors as part of movement, although that one was a kind of a special one, so I'll go ahead and say that, yeah, that would probably be a move action. But they're all open now, so it won't impede you any further. Alright, Andrew, when you're ready.
I pulled my scimitar out, just in case.
Sure.
And scimitar is my chair.
Alright, Zig, your turn.
Hmm. Well, seeing this door is open, I'm exploring in there. I'm hopefully not dying.
Some of people gonna die?
About here. That's your way.
Oh, God. What? I just thought of something horrible, but I'm not going to say anything for now.
Alright.
Probably not the case.
So you look in the room and you see exactly what you see. A rather raised platform, kind of pyramid-like fashion. You don't actually see the stairs, however, so you have no idea that they're there.
Don't know if there's anything that will kill us in here.
Not at the moment.
I don't like swearing to say not at the moment.
Foreboding.
You have no idea what any of this is.
I'm but curious moment, how...
It kind of looks like a thing.
It looks like a thing.
Well, seeing as I don't know, in my turn for now, yeah, I'll probably go back to
the one thing
pits.
You do notice, is that on top of the pyramid, you notice, like, a faint glowing. Almost, and you see light rays kind of reaching up into the sky. Almost as if it's in like kind of a circle-ish thing. You don't actually see this design until you actually go up there, of course. But you can't assume something magical's up.
Yeah. Well, now I use a tech check.
See magic.
Yeah.
You detect the magic that's right there.
I detect the magic that I just said was goddamn magical. Oh shit, it's magic.
I'm trying to tell you what type of magic is.
Okay, but you're gonna be sitting there for a bit.
Okay.
Alright. Let's actually put that on your token.
I would wager that's the kind of magic they shouldn't shoot a fireball at. Alright.
Who shoots a fireball at it?
End your turn when you're ready. Webber, it's your turn.
All right. So the door above me is closed now, right?
The door above you is still open. You guys just fell in.
Door above me is still open. Yeah. And how about how far up is it?
Again? 50 feet.
50 feet. Well, I'm going to cast Fly on my armor, and then fly up.
Fly gives you perfect maneuverability, so yeah, you should be able to fly straight up.
Oh yeah,
I don't think so. It says you're going to ascend at half speed, so at full 30 speed feet up.
At that.
Okay, 30 feet up. Yeah, it's still good. Good distance. You'll be out there before the next turn moves.
All right.
Perfect maneuverability lets you fly upwards at full speed.
Blue Moon. Did Steve actually mention that
well,
he could
first,
get
Blue Moon? Well, first, it's the owl's turn. The owl's not long right. Its turn to be whatever.
Yeah, I can get us out of here.
The owl moves towards the open hole door thing.
Y'all hear me?
Yes.
No, he's correct, AJ. He moves at half speed.
It's also in the spell description.
Yeah.
Oh. Okay, well, yeah, the spell description trumps the chart.
Okay. All right, Lumi, what'd you say? I'm sorry.
Oh, it sounded like Steve was going to be able to get us out. I was just double-checking that he actually said it in character, and I believe he said he did.
Yeah, Steve says he's got this.
He says muffled and broken bones and dirt.
Awesome. It's too bad it's not Lumi's turn yet, though.
I've done this turn. Before!
That's more important than his turn.
So the owl.
That's right. It is owl's turn. Owl's kind of who's. I guess he's going to try and get to the closest point where Quibor is, because that's what he does, and he has not received any new orders.
The owl. James says, look, there's a pyramid in that room.
The owl completely bypasses you.
Hootie-hoo.
As it is currently trying to return to the person who summoned it, and it has not received any new orders.
Anti-social sumbitch.
It's a summon creature. Lumi, it's your turn.
Alright.
Yeah, I'll get to the middle of town.
Dean Quibor starting to fly his way up, and he's just kind of like, hey, he tried to meet up with Steve. I think we're both pretty beat up.
I'm just imagining, like, Quibor just suddenly starts ascending, doesn't even say shit to you guys. You're like, what a dick, God.
He's just like, yeah.
Well, I think he did say, don't worry about me. I got my own passage covered since Steve could only grab one. And then...
Yeah.
I'm gonna delay until after Steve.
Okay. Let's see. We'll put you down at 4. Cool. Neely's turn.
Neely's gonna take her crossbow out. Walk in here. If it'll let me. And look around.
Neely.
Do things.
Okay. Neely, you see a lot of stuff in this room. You also see Zig as you walk in at the other side, just kind of staring intently with glowing blue pupils in his eyes. There's a lot of architecture in here. You also see a little groove where some stairs ascend the pyramid. You see little glowing bits at the top here that you can't actually determine what they are, but you see them glowing.
Is the architecture in any kind of design that would denote that it was built for a specific purpose?
Roll in knowledge architecture if you have it.
He does.
Roll it.
Let me find it. Knowledge architecture. That one right there. Bam.
No, it is not any purpose that you can determine, unfortunately.
Take some pictures because she's into architecture.
Yeah, you've seen a lot of stuff. This is not something you've seen before.
Okay.
Whoops. Activate the Tara!
Crap. Yeah, she ends her turn, and then she's gonna go check out that glowing at the top the next turn.
What?
Any dimension doors. Takes Lumi with him, and he gotta go much over here.
Okay, you're gonna have to go right here, because it has to be
that's
a place
fine.
You can see. Okay,
that's fine.
So you guys are going to be a little cramped, but it should be fine and easy to do. I need to.
He just lays on the floor going, ah, I hate.
Okay.
That's what he does until his next turn. If Steve just says they're going, I want to go home.
Okay, end your turn, please. Jimmy, you are now at the top of the pit. Yay!
Yay!
See a giant white owl just kind of sitting there going, whoo.
Wee-hoo.
Do you recognize it as like being friendly or somewhat?
Well, it doesn't seem to be attacking you. It's just kind of standing at the edge of the pit, ruffling its feathers a little bit.
He said Carbor summoned things before, so probably could put that figured out.
That looks like an infernal owl. Kill it!
Can I use an action to pick Steve up? To, like, kind of help stand him up?
Yeah, standard action? You're, like, grabbing him?
Yeah, just
popping him up.
Helping him up, basically. Yeah, and saying thanks real quick for...
But you're touching him.
You're out.
He stands up, yeah, and his right leg, like, bends in half on the lower part.
Can I make that move? Like, I don't know.
I don't know, because you're going to be squeezing through that area. It's going to be half movement, but that's
right,
it.
But, like,
this is an area these doors have never been open before. Are you literally just going to walk into a territory you've never been into?
No, that's a true point, but... So Lumu instead is just gonna be like, up to here, see the door is open, and I consider, like, she's kind of got the idea how the trap moves around the room, I assume, right? Is she's been able to see up in different places and different corners and feel the movement?
I would say that you get the idea that it moves about in kind of like a ring shape, but you don't really know where it has been opening up, because to you, everything is four squares of green ceiling.
Right.
And occasionally you might see a door out of the corner of the trap. That's about it.
Because, like, I feel like she'd want to, like, get off of that area at least. Does that kind of...
There's no way to guarantee that from your perspective.
Yeah.
Unless you were to get out of this general area. Damn it. Again, your character has been basically looking at the same ceiling tiles forever.
So, with her desire to be away from any possible trap doors, would she enter that room?
I kind of feel like yes, but I don't know. I'm trying to just sort of picture, if that makes sense, like, because it seems like the way that it's moving around and such in circular motion, she could kind of feel the way it's moving and get the idea that it's going around. But
for what's worth, you do have enough movement to move to about right here in the room if you were to do that. That said, you also know that here's the door, it looks like the door that you came in from. Although, from your perspective, you just got out of a hole, you have no idea where the fuck you are. Except for in the place right across from the owl.
Yeah. Alright. Well, I guess she would maybe just move here for now.
Okay.
And just be like, Steve, like, what, you know, it seemed like it was moving around a lot, like, you know, what's going on with this? Been up here a bit.
I know shit. I know that I fell in it twice since pissed.
Alright.
Tribor, you hear the whirrings around you start to activate.
Oh no.
Oh no.
Steve and Lumu, both of you. Steve, Lumu, and Desilo all roll listen checks.
Oh, I forgot that one's on the main page.
Oh,
Okay, only Quibor hears anything. Everybody else is just like, okay. Neslo, it's your turn.
Alright. I'm going to...
just saw Zig walk off and go do stuff.
Yeah, I'm going to follow Zig. And what was... it was a standard action to re-equip all my stuff?
Is Swift, which is basically a free action that you can do once per round, and it has penalties in the mid. You basically you can't do anything. You can't have an immediate action, which is basically like it doesn't matter for you. Does not matter.
Not like actually how that works.
Okay. Okay. I would like to move in front of Zig. Is that a pillar right there?
This thing.
Yes.
That is a small pedestal. Reaches about your waist.
Okay. Well, I'm going to stand there. Once I get there, I will re-equip all my gear.
Okay. I'm going to have you kind of move over here, though, because you have to go through a straight line through that door.
Okay.
All right, you equip all your gear. Good, you're back in full armor.
All right, do I need to do that, or have you okay. got it?
No, I can click the button.
Okay.
All right, and now you have your tower shield back. All right, Lumu, regarding swift actions, are they not like free actions that you get one of each turn, or do they not do did not allow you to have immediate action in the following round that you're doing?
They don't cancel out your following immediate action. An immediate action will cancel out your next swift action, but not the other way around.
Fine.
Okay. Right.
James, it's your turn.
All right. James walks in here. And looks around. Sees Deslo. Says, hey, what y'all doing over there? Y'all find Lumu?
Can I hear that?
Deslo would say, no.
Roll listen check.
No, but anything to get out of that ring.
You know what? I don't blame you. I about fell in one of those, but, motherfuckers.
Let's see, what's the distance we're looking at? Just keep moving shit that I'm not meaning to move. Kind of going through a bit of wall, but there is a hole there. Yeah, you do manage to hear that, Lemu.
Like, oh, Steve got me out of the hole. I'm over here. What's going on?
Oh, we found a black pyramid.
That's racist.
That's black.
Racist.
He's gonna start walking that way. He heard.
It's the black pyramids of Seoul. I think more wasted.
Honest racism.
There's some glowing stuff at the top. It might be magic.
True. Is Steve still alive? At your current angle, you can see Steve.
Hey, Steve. There's some magic in here. Don't blow it up.
Fuck you guys.
Silver, staring at stuff. Suddenly, Deslo enters your view and uses his ring. A ring, your vision is filled with a giant splurge of magic all over him.
Splurge.
He turns the doors back down into the hole and just lays down and goes to sleep. Stays in there.
It sounds like he was trying to find me with his magical ring. I should slap him.
You might be distracted.
The royal constriction?
No, it's not a big deal. I assume you're still staring and you've seen it multiple times. Alright, I forget. What is the second round of Detect Magic actually let you know?
Let me look at it real quick.
I'm looking as well. Alright, second round. Number of different magical orcas and the power... orcas? Different magical orcas. Fuck, there's four different magical orcas that suddenly show up and they just start...
Not again!
Oh no!
I'm wondering how many drugs I'm taking right now.
That happened before.
What happened?
He brought the orcas in or whatever when we were in the one room.
Yeah, the fucking whale people. Alright, yeah. Alright, what'd you say, Silver?
drink. Oh, no, God. No,
don't worry about it.
Okay. Number of different magical auras. There's two of them, clearly. There's probably several of them because, well, actually, in your vision, there's only two.
James Deslo. Just walked, right?
Yeah, that's true. You kind of see a little bit of James' equipment, but then again, you've seen that before. Again, you see Deslo suddenly flashing in auraness, and then you see the one on top there. The one on top is extremely powerful. It's not overwhelming, but it's powerful enough for you to determine that it is a significant major device. Magic device, excuse me.
Okay.
Don't blow it up, Bird.
Alright, you guys still concentrate?
Yep.
Yep. Alright. Rybor. You're 30 feet up out of the hole. Fly another 30 feet up of that hole. Be completely clear of the pit.
I will do that.
One square outside of it.
I will do that. And upon exiting the pit, I will see that this door has opened, and I will fly through the door.
Very well.
So I'll go there.
Okay. Let's see. First off, so.
And then I'll keep on going. To there.
Okay. Burglar, you step into a magical room of magic with everybody walking around, kind of sightseeing. Everybody seems to be very interested in this room.
Yep. Also, my character's kind of going to be like floating up in the air.
Very well.
That bullshit doesn't have to do.
Are you floating up?
It's like a watery floating thing.
Oh god. It became gigantic.
I was trying to signify that as you getting close to the camera, just like when you fell, you're like, "Wee."
Yeah.
Anyways, but yeah, so yeah, you're sitting here like kinda floating around, you see the thing.
Neely walks past Quabor. Hey, how you doing? And continues on.
Found a hole.
Neely, you walk up to the top of the damn stairs. At the top of the stairs at least. When you get to the top, you see, like, a very, very large, very intricate, very, very painstakingly etched magical circle that is glowing a lot of prismatic light all everywhere.
Yeah.
It's clearly active.
Do I know anything?
I don't know, do you?
He has knowledge, Arcana.
Roll it, then.
Also, I forgot to activate it, so if you want to knock off a couple turns for that, cell.
She doesn't touch it. She doesn't enter the circle.
My duration.
She's just looking.
Gotcha.
This spell.
Okay, cool. She's just looking. Well, let's see. From what you are able to gather, it's a very intricate circle. Given how large it is and given the amount of detail, what you're able to determine from it is that it was clearly meant to be a permanent fixture, or rather, at least a long-term fixture. Other than that, you're not able to determine its function or what it actually... I mean, you're just not able to determine its function. You are able to determine just from its use what it's actually being used for, or rather, or how it would normally be used. It's very significant. It's meant to be there for a long time. This is not something you just toss down somewhere.
But so this is from way back.
No, that is not something you're able to determine. You were able to determine that it is something that was put down for long-term use. That's it. Basically, what you're able to determine is that people would not normally just go somewhere and decide to throw down a fucking magic circle of this detail or size. It's not something you do just out on whim. It's something you do because you plan to be here for a while or use it several times. That's all you're getting out of this.
She looks around and says, okay, this thing was meant for long-term use, but I don't know anything else. Where's the wizard? The sorcerer, whatever he is.
Are you a wizard?
Zig and Deslo both see Neely summit pyramid.
Are you a god?
Yes.
Can we see the glowy? We can see the glowiness, right?
You see, I think my character was you see her standing on the other side of the glowiness looking at it.
She holds your arms up, Mike, just starts going, oh!
Alright, end your turn if you're ready.
Stab staff goes. I want to go into the build. I want to go into the building. Into the room.
Okay.
Yes, I try to go slowly and carefully as possible. Get right there without dying in a hole.
Down in a hole.
I go, Crackboy, you know those heal spells?
By the way, you have another movement or a standard action?
I still got my wand out, don't I?
I did not make you roll to drop it like I should have, so technically you still have it.
Okay, that was supposed to be Neely saying that, but...
Okay. James is talking to himself.
It's supposed to be Neely.
I know.
Okay. I didn't know if you heard or not.
Yeah. I was just being silly.
I hear you.
No, I'm Desolo. What?
Well, Desolo said, Neely, be careful. James said, I am being careful, James. And so Lumu said, no, I'm Desolo.
Okay, well, that was supposed to be Neely that said that.
It's a joke. Actually, that's not true. So. But it is a joke.
It's a joke.
Confused. It should be an OOC.
You confuse Deslo for James. Which I know isn't what happened. But...
That was a side.
Oh my god, Steve. Please finish your last action.
Yes, please.
I cast Cure Light Wounds on myself.
Alright. Alright, it looks like you get 9 HP out of that one.
Pimpin'. Still beat up pretty badly.
Yes, please make sure to heal yourself with it. If I had a way to convert this to healing, that would be super great, but there is no way to do so.
Hmm.
Alright. Are you make sure you're subtracting your charges, by the way.
I did. It's down 29. Yeah.
All right, and end your turn. Were you ready? Lumu, he gets up and he just kind of leaves you there.
Well, I mean, it's the turn system, so.
Oh yeah, so I forgot actually. You can keep doing yours. Owl just kind of like, oh hey, Webber's over here.
Caca.
Tries to land on his shoulder.
Too big. Crushes him.
God,
so, how tall is this pyramid?
What's worth, you did move through that. You were squeezing. You had to stop there and then use your other movement to continue. Because that would be, you can move about 30 feet. And that was 35 to get right here. Continue.
Well, I just like it's one square of half speed or twice. I would think that would be like minus 5 off my total. Like, I mean, I guess I'm 2 squares of person moving through the 1 square thing, so it makes sense.
Right.
All right. So, how tall is this? Yeah.
These are about 7 feet tall or so from up the next level. So these stairs are a pretty steep incline. That means that at the end of it, you're looking at about maybe 20 or 28. 7 feet tall. Yeah, there you go. There you go, 28. Sounds good.
Oh.
The size of a small building.
Let's see. I guess we would hang out here for the moment and just sort of, say hey to Quiborg and wait for him to come over to heal him both
and Steve,
with his touchy heal.
You just stepped on.
Yeah. Well, I didn't want to.
No, just ready. Alright.
So,
All right. So. Top of the round, stuff's happening outside the ring, but no one is out there, so it doesn't matter.
Alright.
I'll just go ahead and say that any of you who are particularly observant can hear the thing go moving around.
Yeah. There you go.
All right, yeah, y'all rolling this place, kind of looking at stuff. Deslo, it's your turn.
How tall are these steps of the pyramid type thingy?
7 feet. Okay. 7 feet.
Sorry, I wasn't paying attention.
The top of it is at 28 feet.
That's okay.
Sorry.
Literally, that conversation literally just ended.
Sorry, I wasn't paying attention. All right.
It's fine.
Okay, so I'm going to try and join everybody. And I can only move that far. With my armoire. Right. Where is my combat tracker?
All of you on this side, you suddenly hear something going. And then maybe Quibor can start suddenly see like a Deslo shape coming out. Everybody can generally see Deslo coming out from over on the side of the pyramid.
Yes, I can. Yeah.
Of this guy. James, your turn. Limu and Steve enter the room as well as an owl and a Quibor.
Sing the dog pile over. Yeah. He's gonna join. Not really.
Dog
I do
want to
pass them though. If I can grab the thing afterwards. There we go. Ha ha.
Ha ha.
He's gonna double move over here because it's getting crowded over down that way.
All right.
And he's just gonna lean up against the wall and wait.
Okay, well, as you move over there, you lean up against the wall, you see, Deslo hustling over here in full plate. All right, and Zig, it is your turn. This turn, you managed to determine that this is a very strong conjuration aura.
It's going to conjure stuff.
Well, gonna be,
it's gonna start the conjuring schools.
No, conjuration does many different things in the conjuration schools. It is very possible that it
may conjure teleportation, possibly.
Also a possibility. It could also heal you, strangely enough, because for some reason healing is part of conjuration.
Did I hear?
Am I
picking anything up from that pedestal that's partially in my sight?
No, you pick up nothing from the pedestal, strangely enough.
Did I hear,
so did anyone get that joke?
No. Did I hear Lumu and Neely's conversation? Or did that occur before I started running to that side?
Lumu and Neely's conversation? I'm gonna say that you're within enough distance that even while you were on the other side, you were kind of hearing it kind of echo above. And you could always hear Neely.
Okay.
I would start heading towards others.
Okay.
Oh, let them know that it's conjuration circle. That's what it does. Not 100% sure.
Okay. Oh,
shit. Accidentally closed the map.
That note that was in that with that scroll case and the key was like they were basically saying they were storing their useful supplies and such, right?
Right.
Aye.
Yeah.
Aye.
Alright. I guess I will go over and heal the weekend and the suffering.
Everybody's healing for the weekend.
So Steve then.
No, I'm smacking Steve across the face. Like, you need a bit of awakening. Alright, can I do the thing where I can heal multiple people at once, or...?
You cannot. That is a four-round action. You can hold a charge, but in order to heal the multiple people, it is a four-round. Which is why it's usually used after battle, or... like that.
Okay.
You can pass this turn and do it.
I guess
technically right now, we're not really doing anything in particular, but there's a reason I have to kind of keep you guys in the combat tracker.
Okay. Oh, wait.
It's an extremely unlikely reason, but it's a reason nonetheless.
That's all my
retaining those pits, actually, because if y'all get anywhere near those, I have to, like, keep y'all in this damn thing.
Also, the celestial hoots. First turn.
Go, Hooter, go.
Stands there, staring into your soul. And you start to question your existence.
Bruh. And then she's going to feel like I'm moving something that's not kneeling. There. Yeah. Because that's what I, that's what I grabbed right there. There. So, Neely's gone.
Neely gets destroyed by the stairs.
Thank you. And she's gonna walk over here. And then turn back and say, follow me, I'll show you where the chest is. And end her turn.
Okay. This is the point in case why I had to keep you guys in the combat track here.
Oh boy. There we go.
Okay.
What are happenings?
Well, they're about to leave the room, which means they're going back into the ring, so it's very potential that they might fall in a hole, which means I have to keep them in the combat trigger.
Oh. Okay.
I was honestly, like, really worried they were going to be in this ring also.
Yeah.
Steve is currently underneath Lumu because Lumu walked in on top of him.
Go over here and talk to Zig.
Wait, Steve. Steve, wait. He's, Quibor's waiting to full turn heal us both.
Oh, well, Steve does jack shit until.
Yeah. Alright, Lumu will also wait.
And don't worry, guys, I have a plan for.
I'm sure you.
For this whole thing outside.
Alright.
And it involves Neely. Can't get anybody out of a hole. Make sure nobody goes into one.
Alright. So we decided we're not going to fuck around with this thing.
For the moment. Lubu, was Lubu based off a real person?
Lubu? Yes, he was. Or at least he was based off of a legendary person. The actual character of the person is disputed.
Alright, I would like to go here and listen to see if I can see any worrying abouts on this hallway here.
Okay, roll me a listen check, please. Oh yeah, that's right, yeah. The hallway seems rather quiet for now, actually.
Okay, how far did I just move?
15 feet.
Neely says, don't go out yet. Let me test it.
Okay. All right. Well, I don't know what her test involves, so I'm going to ready the action to grab her should it open up beneath her and end my turn.
Okay. And float.
Well, I don't know that.
James, you both go in the hole. Is going to delay after Neely.
All right. Let's see, what is that? That is number 5, I believe. Yep.
Yep.
Well, Zig's turn.
Yep. Zigster.
Zig, the entire party's back here together. You're no longer a loan shark. Excuse me, I mean loner.
I'm feeling the need to run away from the party.
Also, we killed the last thing and nothing bad happened so far.
So my hunch so far was wrong, which is good. I prefer to be wrong on that.
I'm kind of hoping it's a healing circle. It would be nice.
For some reason, I highly doubt that.
Well, they always show up before the boss battle, so, you know.
So y'all gonna go out and play at the chests and possibly fall into traps?
Possibly.
Yes.
Go play with the chest and not fall in any traps.
Y'all want me to lead the way, seeing as I can fall and not actually fall?
Neely can
oh,
I think.
Oh, yeah. Well, then. I was chilling here for now. Which, right here.
Y'all seem to forget, she has a 15 feet fly speed.
I didn't.
My plan is to have her fly out of her just above the floor and then push her foot down against it. Kind of like she's stepping on it, but she's still flying.
After I move there, I will stare at this circle because it looks evil. I don't trust it.
You should use fireball on it.
I don't plan on pulling this, Steve.
Okay. No hit it with your glaive.
Yeah, I'll pass on that.
Just poke it. What's the worst that could happen?
Put your hand in there. See what happens.
Fireball's turn.
I whisper to Lumu and Steve's ears.
Prepare for the healing.
I'm so glad
you do realize if you take this healing that you have to worship Qui-Bor as your only god.
Yes, I know. I rolled two. I accidentally took one off my thing.
Jimbo did not like that idea so much that he left.
Jimbo is at full health. Somehow. And then the healing ceased. My celestial owl said,
and now you have two followers. Your religion has begun. Alright. He's gonna fly out here. And float just above the floor and put her foot down on the floor. Like she's taking a step while still flying.
Alright. As she taps down, nothing happens.
Says, okay, I think it's good. So she lands and she walks this way. If nothing happens.
Nothing happens.
And she walks that way.
All right.
James, here he exists, walks out, confident, and then stops right there, beside her.
James suddenly gets impaled on a spike number.
Oh god.
Look, I've been impaled. Alright.
My body's never made that noise before.
Lurch. So James, as you walk over here and Ely shows you the way, she arrives at a closed cabinet. On the other end of it, you see kind of an open cabinet that has signs of someone having searched in it.
Interesting. What about the other one? No? Shit. Okay. I'll check it in a minute. It is Steve's turn.
Yeah, well, Steve's just gonna sit there because he's spoiled for it.
Well, that's because he's not on anymore. I think he timed out or something.
No, I was just being facetious.
He leaved.
I don't know what the word for that is. He leaved because he didn't want to sit here and play. Anyways, yeah. So Steve being Steve decides to go up there and look at the thing. He decides to study the thing for a long time. So he's sitting there with his hand on his chin going, Sure.
Oh God.
As the Steve's size is slightly off.
Thank Squiborg for the healing.
Dick has been crushed.
She'll hang out here and wait for the other guys to come back from checking out the chest or whatnot. Can she kind of, well, I guess kind of see Neely, right?
It is mine turn.
No, you cannot. Her line to Neely goes through a wall.
Yeah, I guess so, huh?
Yeah. Actually, it goes for two walls. The edge right on the door and the edge over here.
Run.
Oh, yeah.
So she cannot see.
It goes through all the walls.
Well, she'll give a little shout out, like, just, you know, let me know if you guys need me over there, but I'm pretty fine staying inside here for now.
All right.
Don't worry, we understand. You stay in there. Don't follow any holes.
Zig, you're being left behind, except you're being left behind with others who are doing other things.
I'm just going to wait for the others to get back.
Blister all turns and looks at you, Zig, and says,
I kind of raise my eyebrow and stare at it.
Yes. I'm going to go in and join up there with Steve, I think.
Whiteboard passes by. Great owl goes,
I think the owl
should touch the circle and see what happens.
That could be a bad idea.
I too shall examine the circle if I can.
I mean, circle. You're gonna take
it. Not sure.
So, do you have spellcraft, right?
Yep.
All right. You wanna take 20, take 10? What are you doing? Or just wanna roll?
I'm gonna roll.
Okay.
If he said he could take 20, I'd take 20.
If we take 20, do we still get the skill point bonus?
No.
I'm sure Steve is taking 20.
I take 20 on all of my checks from now on.
Quaibor, you were unable to determine anything new about this.
Damn it.
It is a very complex magical circle.
Say, come over here and look at the circle. Oh, my turn.
Suddenly the circle explodes and kills all three of the party's mages.
I am not a mage. Also, the whole hoots.
You are totally a mage.
I'm a cleric.
You are a white mage, okay?
Nobody fucks with the white mage.
True.
Mage stands for magician. You use magic.
Alright, so. And Neely does not count as a mage because she is an enchanter.
That's still a mage, but it's different because you don't really have spells.
She opens it, walks straight through.
Does indeed.
They just. This.
Yeah.
I did perfectly.
No, you didn't. You threw the damn other part of the damn thing.
Okay, try it now.
Okay.
Dang it. Why is this thing so wonky? Wanted her in the corner of the freaking all I want.
Okay, there you go.
Then she, like, stands by the chest in, like, showgirl style, holding her arms out towards it. And she ends her turn.
Okay. James's turn.
James walks through, stands right beside it. He's gonna search the shit.
Okay. The chest does appear to, once you try to open it, what are you actually doing?
I'm searching for traps.
Okay. Before you just, I'm going to search this shit. All right, roll your search check. you don't find anything of note.
Okay. Sorry, I've been making like a whole thing about how Neely wanted him to search for traps, so.
I did not hear that. I heard, I want James to come find this, no one else. That's it. I assume she was just planning to keep this.
Oh, well, it was in the chat.
Okay, fine.
It was in the chat, I remember that.
That's fine. So,
alright. So, anyways, he finds nothing, so he goes to open it. Did I lose connection?
No.
Oh. Just make sure you're done.
All right. So you open the chest. It's a very old and musty chest. It's very ancient. It seems like it's been here for quite some time. You open the chest, and you find some interesting little trinkets in it. All of them seem to be bagged, however. You have no idea what's in these bags. But they all look to be of various shapes and sizes.
Can I start going through them, or...?
1 second.
I know what they are. They're our ultimate weapons. Lumos is just a big gauntlet with bikes all over it. Quibors is a staff with a hand in the shape of a bird finger at the top.
All right. And not an arc. Okay, there's four things, there's four bags in there. One of them's pretty, two of them are actually pretty big. The others are rather small. You mentioned you were going through them, which one are you going through first?
The one that looks like it's the most medium-sized one out of the bunch.
Okay, this one's about the size of a small basketball, about. You open it up, and it actually looks to be a bunch of chain-linked armor. It's, when you pull it out, it's a pile of chainmail about the size of a tunic.
Cool.
We're putting that in a pretty sheet. Alright. I'm actually just gonna start putting a lot of these in here. Some of the easy ones anyways. The other one. Okay. Okay, cool. Alright, so you, there's four items in there. Apparently there's another scroll, a symbol of sleep that someone found and never took out of the party sheet. Although I'm pretty sure it was Steve who identified it.
I thought Steve said he took it.
He probably did, but he never took it out. You have to actually take it.
Ah.
Like, you drag that to your party, to your character sheet when you take something. Out of the party sheet. Basically, it's like saying, I took it, and leaving it on the ground and leaving. That's okay. I'll put it in there. Alright. Well, on the party sheet, if you go to the inventory tab, there are four items there. Two of them are pretty easy to identify. They are a short bow and a chain shirt. The other two are very interesting. One is, when you open the bag, it actually seems to be like a kind of like just a dust collector. But it's inside the bag. There's a very long case. The case is about as long as your forearm. And when you open it up, there's a roll of paper in it. The other bag actually doesn't seem to have a whole lot in it, except for what can only be described as a lot of glitter. Clearly, it may not be just glitter, but you know, glitter.
I give the two unidentified items to Healy to identify. And I'll take the chain shirt and short bow.
All right. Drag them to your character out of your inventory out of the party sheet.
Just like the portrait? Or
no, to your inventory.
I like that. I like that a lot. All right.
Okie dokie. That's everything that you found in the chest. Everything else, it seems to be pretty barren. The rest of it is completely unusable.
All right, he takes those out and then stands up and goes, all right, that's everything I found. Everything else looks like baubles.
Hey, baubles just trash. It's all been rotted. Oh, all right, you're talking about the two things that Neely got. I don't know.
All right. And he's going to end his turn there.
Okay. Steve. He's still sitting there, and at the thing. He can tell he's still focusing on it. Lum's turn.
Did Lumu see? Probably not see this, though. Okay. I don't think I've got a whole lot going on. I guess I'll just I'll roll a listen check to see if I hear anything moving around to kind of an eye out. Not really an eye out, but you know.
You don't really hear a whole lot. You hear the movements of your friends up here. You hear Steve constantly saying, Occasionally the owl here will bristle.
Okay, I'm just going to keep hanging out and waiting for everyone to regroup.
If you would have rolled a natural 20, you would have heard the bird's thoughts, and they would not be nice.
Does the hallway go any further to the left?
It does not. That's a wall. Actually, I should do something real quick. Everyone. Just for kicks, roll a balance check.
Oh, shit, son.
Every single person.
It's bad news for me.
It really is. Everybody's doing good in the tower, so.
Okay. Oh, yeah, hold on. I gotta do Steve, right? I should have just rolled a party roll, but whatever. Okay.
Wow. They did it.
Every single person does better. Everybody's like rolling high in the 20s or double digits, and Slow's over here with a 4.
Okay.
Okay, so guys, the entire tower starts shaking. Like, everywhere. These guys are being affected. You in here are being affected. Lumu's over here being affected. This pillar's being affected and it falls down.
Wait, how am I being affected? I'm floating.
Okay. Good point. You're not, you don't have to worry about it. But all the stuff's being affected. So, the pillar also stands back up. clearly, something major, big is going down. The tremors are getting bigger, stronger, and they just keep happening. Eventually, they die down to a manageable level, but you guys can tell that you've been wasting too much time.
Oh, no.
Lies. Something is happening. Like, that's the first thing that pops into each and every one of your minds is, oh, shit, we had a time limit, didn't we?
No. Okay. Oh, I'm sorry. I never ended my turn, did I? I'm sorry.
No, your turn just began.
Oh, okay. I would like to get back to my feet.
It happens at the top of the round. You're just the first person.
Okay. I'd like to get back to my feet.
Move action.
Okay. All right.
Alright, I'm going to... Doom us to potholes.
Best Doomistopheles, man.
I know.
Doomistapholes.
Doomistapholes. Doomistapholes.
Alright. I'll make my way here. Listen for any worryings about.
The tower shook. It must be the Boston Red Sox.
What? What?
I mean, Doomistapholes. Anyways, yeah, you listen for your words. Go ahead and roll your listen check.
Listen for the worryings about.
No, you don't seem to hear any worryings.
Okay, we're going to shoot across. Whoops. Two. Say, so I moved what, 5? To here. Back to whence I came.
Eslo. Eslo, roll a reflex save.
Oh, balls.
Did not hear any worms, but you win with a 5. Oh, but you totally managed to save it. There's your listen, and there's your reflex. You're like, fuck!
But.
Yeah.
This boat did not fall in a hole.
We're so fucked. Yep.
Bullshit.
As you stepped on guys, the apocalypse is on. And you like fucking jump back with your hands on the wall, like, oh shit.
Well, guys, I think we're all gonna die.
Yeah, probably. Alright.
It's good knowing you.
Well, guys, it was good playing with y'all, but apparently we did not get there in time. Probably my fault somehow, but. I'm going to blame Steve and Zig, even though he's been here the shortest amount of time out of anybody.
I think you've been here the shortest amount of time. That'll stand sick.
You realize you're not dead.
Thing is, like,
out, I'm getting there!
All right.
Eslo just avoided falling in a pit in the days. The omen.
It's the first seal of the apocalypse, I'm just saying. James not stealing something is like the third. Steve being cheerful is like the last.
That is the pretty much unlikely thing to happen.
Alright. Yeah. Alright, that would end that.
Bloop. You have a move action.
I have a suggestion, Deslo. Maybe you should like put your armor away to hop across that pit.
No. No. I'm gonna
maybe
stay where I am.
Put your armor away and walk the other way.
Just so you know, there, you guys realize there are other doors.
Yeah, I only have like five more feet to go anyway.
I know, I'm just saying. Okay, yeah, that's fine. I was just suggesting because there are other entrances that you guys could use.
Yeah, but I was trying to make my way north.
Zig? Gotcha. Zig, you're moving up there to look at the thing for Koibor?
Yep. We roll Knowledge Arcana or Spellcraft?
This is Spellcraft.
Yep.
Oh, wow. Mm-hmm. Please add a +1 to your spellcraft score.
Yay!
Wait.
Nice.
Alright. You determine this is a very, very, very powerful, combined with the knowledge you had earlier especially, you determine that this is a teleportation sigil. And judging from the way it is oriented, it teleports you straight up.
Hey, we could use that.
You can also tell this is not something that would have been present several thousands of years ago based on your knowledge of magical theory. This is recent.
Just had a thought. Jim Astonis put it there, he's probably got the other entrapped.
If he thinks we can even get there.
Well, it's kind of unfortunate we don't exactly have the time to sort this out.
Yeah, save the world.
I mean, we got a chance
to. Just thinking for a month of what this thing is.
We got a chance it.
I don't know, Zeke. What are you doing there?
I think he's just gonna like not tell anyone. He's just gonna watch us. I'm so like freak out.
At the type.
Yeah, I know. So I was like, why did I put type?
It's time to go, guys.
Dumb asshole.
Dumb asshole.
Was that not his name? I could have sworn that was his name.
Type.
We would kind of yell that information along to James and say, let's get going.
James, the information.
James says, Neely, you'll have to identify those things later. Let's get the fuck out of here.
We gotta move.
And then both him and Neely swiftly run out the door and leave y'all's asses here.
Zig, when you are done, I need you to end your turn.
Welcome to being an NPC 101, James.
Can I just hop on the teleportation circle now?
You can if you want to.
Wait.
You want to be the only one going.
Yeah, it's gonna suck when you're the only person up there. Shit, y'all get crushed by stairs.
I told you, trap. It was trap.
Bloop.
The stairs are mangry.
Well, imagine y'all are gonna be shortly behind me.
Yeah, matter. But I mean, James is, and Neely's bullet. Coming from a different room. So is Destiny.
Fine, I'll wait for you, fags.
No, no, do what you're gonna do. Do what you're gonna do.
I hop on then.
There you go. Well, go for it, man. Much of y'all a choice in the matter. Steve just sits there and goes, yes, I arrived at much the same. Hey, what the fuck are you doing? And then suddenly you disappear.
Well,
okay.
He was with Domastana, whatever his name is. Alum.
So, Silver, you suddenly feel yourself, you're lurching forward, and then it's like the entire world starts moving around you. You are flying upwards at an incredibly speedy pace, but still at a pace where you can still observe things around you. It's almost as if you're ethereal right now while you're traveling.
And you hit the ceiling.
It's almost like you're not instantaneously traveling, but you're just moving while ethereal at an incredibly fast pace upwards. So it's a little bit different from the knowledge you got because your spellcraft was not able to fully determine it. He would have told you this had you let him finish doing his rules and then let him and listen to him instead of jumping on it. That's fine. Not a big deal. In fact, you get to see this. In the meantime, Steve's sitting here and watching you disappear. And he's like, motherfucker, everybody get in here. We have to go after him.
Like, son of a bitch.
Yep. Oh, by the way, Zig, will you do me a favor and roll a spot check in the power?
Sure. I can go blind. I think I used up my natural 20 for the week.
Interesting.
For the week, huh?
But I go blind.
For the month. How about your turn?
Yeah.
Yes, it is.
Yeah, it is.
Go. A friend of yours just jumped on a circle and got disintegrated.
A friend.
Yeah, I don't think I'm a friend. He hates me.
Okay. A potential follower of your own sect of religion.
Is he a follower of the Great Mother?
No, he's the
calling bullshit.
Potentially.
Why?
Quadbor has decided that he's going to be a god.
he believes in Bicor and Mana.
Hmm.
He's not too faithful to one.
My guy will walk over to Steve, and I'll be like, I'm going to have to make sure he doesn't kill himself.
No, we're all going. This has been six seconds of him jumping into this. Like, Steve's also moving in the same direction. He's intending to go up there. He also just shouted at everybody to get in here and get up onto the circle.
So, yeah, so we're all going, right? Like, waiting for everyone to go.
You know, it's going to be hilarious.
It's like, everybody get up there as soon as possible, is what he's saying.
Okay.
Yeah.
You know, it's going to be hilarious. We're all going to start heading up there. The last person behind is going to fall into the hole and get stuck.
Going to cast my divine power on myself and then go in the circle.
Okay. Webber, you get mostly the same. Oh, I should actually do this motion. Why does it do this? Hate it.
Actually, what's going to be funny is when Deslo goes to jump on it and finds the one hole in it and falls all the way to the bottom.
Webber, you step on the thing and you also zoom upwards. Webber, please roll me a perception check.
Okay.
Or a spot check, excuse me. Okay. Quibor, you are kind of blinded by the insanity of this fast travel. Everything's completely white around you. It's like you were not prepared for ethereal travel.
Is this like the Willy Wonka thing?
No, just, what Willy Wonka thing?
I don't know, like the Willy Wonka tunnel thing.
You mean the thing where they're, like, floating on the bubbles and stuff up towards the fan?
No, you mean it was the boat ride? The boat ride. Please tell me you remember that.
Ride. I don't remember the boat ride. I'm sorry.
That's like the most terrifying, nightmarish thing ever.
Well, this isn't extremely nightmarish. It's just, you know, your eyes haven't adjusted to the ethereal travel, so everything's just completely white.
All right. Well.
Aurelius, please, in your turn.
Okay. The owl follows.
Turn, technically, the owl does follow. However, as soon as the owl touches the circle, it disappears, and you do not see it follow behind you.
Oh, it banishes summoned creatures.
Neely, your turn.
Neely comes out of the closet, and seeing the
I knew
there,
it.
Runs down that way.
It's good that you finally let everyone know that you're living.
Okay.
Look, they were playing 7 minutes in heaven, okay? They only got through 2 seconds. Then y'all had to scream for them. So yeah, it's her turn, because that's a double move. And James is going to follow right after her. And he can't really go anywhere further because she's in the way.
I understand. Alright. Steve, unfortunately, has to comply with his poor judgment and also jumps on the circle. Sumu, sure.
James shouts out, "Go ahead, Lumu, we're right behind you."
Yeah.
Let me roll my bluff check real quick.
Wait, are you fucking leaving? Or not, they're fucking leaving.
They're gone.
It probably won't be too hard to fool her.
You believe me. It doesn't even matter what I say at this point. I could tell you that you were a...
No, you kind of have to stick with what you did say, but...
No, I'm just saying, I could have told her anything and she would have believed.
No, you could have told her that you were her father and she would have had a minus 20 to your roll.
Yeah.
Because that's completely unlikely. But Numu, I am your father. Anyway. Oh, that's just not possible.
Well, really? I never knew. Hi, Dad.
We're Where's all my birthday presents? Your
father's cousin's first uncle's nephew's sister.
I'm kind of like considering grabbing Neely to sort of save time, but
you should.
Just grab both.
You
like,
should.
Right, let's go.
You suddenly should. Steve appears back in the portal and says, "Get up here, goddammit!" and goes back in.
I'm hello. Would Neely like resist being helped along by Lumu?
I don't know. You can grab her and see.
Why? Would yeah. Lumu who cares? Just grab her. Why are you like doing all this right. all the time? Just do it or don't do it.
Fine. Goddamn.
yeah. Well, Lumu's a person who just does shit. You're like all like, you want to do that?
Well, Lumu's that way completely.
When you're unsure of what to do, just roll a dice.
You're Lumu.
Yeah.
With your exactly. first instinct.
Okay, guys. Like I said, lay off. If Diablo wants Lumu to be a cuck, that's fine. I mean, I'm cool with grabbing you, but only if you want to be grabbed. Okay, sorry. That one was just.
Sorry.
Funny. Yeah, do what you got.
Anyway. Man. Yeah, so they're in a rush. Lumu grab Neely and help her along there and get going.
Okay.
Can you roll a grab or whatever?
No, it's sure. pretty easy at this point. Assuming that Neely does not resist. That's up to Neely. Neely, what are you doing?
Neely is going to struggle vainly. I'm going to allow it, but...
Roll opposed grapple.
She is shocked. That's just all it
roll
is.
Roll opposed grapples. Well, we know who the winner is going to be here.
Yeah.
Okay. Neely's coming along for the ride. And then because y'all stepped into a teleporter together, y'all somehow get fused in some terrible amalgamation of Lumu.
Oh, God, fly.
At least tell me that I'm like that Neely is like sticking out of Lumu's shoulder or something.
No, it's going to be.
It's just that now Lumu is now blue.
Neely is going to become a Lumu Mazel.
It's like Lumu is no longer a barbarian. She is now an artificer and is now blue.
A barbarian
and,
artificer.
And actually, by the way, guys, the reason I did that is because Neely had just ran it up to the door and then got grabbed.
She's now called Lumu.
Basically, James, you guys were just running and suddenly a giant hand reaches out of the room and grabs Neely and she's like, ah!
Yeah, pretty much. That's what I'm saying. It's like that. She runs up to the door and then she gets grabbed. It's like, holy shit, what the fuck are you?
Alright, Lumu, go ahead and roll a spot check for me, please. And Neely as well, I suppose. Alright, so you guys are traveling, you see a couple of very, very far ahead, you see, like, distant lights of that are also moving upwards at about the same speed. Just given your own state right now in the ethereal plane, you assume that Vez or the rest of your party members who are also flying up. As you guys are flying up several hundreds of floors of this tower. This was clearly put here to save time, and at this point I think it's no surprise that you all pretty much assume that Demos Thanos or Helion probably did this. Yeah, y'all are going at quite a pace there.
Well, while they're going up
into an artificial Lumu.
While looking up, Neely says, "At least we can be sure that nobody can look up our skirts."
Lumu doesn't have a skirt.
Neely has a skirt.
Yeah, actually, kind of. She's wearing artificer clothing. So, well, yeah, artist Lumu, clothes.
Yeah, Lumu looks like this, anyways. But she doesn't really have like a skirt. She says leather.
Loading. She looks like a couple of cards with loading.
Well, never mind.
She looks like a real card.
There you go.
Okay. Well. So yeah.
Loading.
All right. Well, Lumu, please end your turn when you can.
Oh, my bad. I forgot.
All right. I would say to James, well, do I know what's going on in there, actually? I guess not.
So basically, let's work just setting the scene here, Deslo. As you're saying this, as James comes hurriedly running out of this room in this direction, say really quickly, you're just like, hey, man, what's going on in there?
Okay. Can I make it through that doorway without having to make any checks to get over the little corner of that hole?
No. You will have to make checks. However, it would probably be significantly easier if you put away your armor. In this case, it would be a balancing check because you're basically edging along the side of the wall. Very quickly hopping.
If you fall, you're all by yourself.
Yes, I am.
If you fall, it's just me. It's just
that
you
would be
and
a
James.
Shitty fate.
Would be a shitty fate.
So, what I would suggest is
this. I forget. Yep.
What?
I would suggest maybe if he takes his armor off and takes 10, if he's guaranteed to get across, maybe doing that. But that, I don't...
Well, taking 10 indicates that it's...
Okay.
You're taking your time doing
it. Okay, no, that's a fair point.
All right, I'm going to toss my everything back in the ring, then.
This is a stressful situation. He doesn't have time to sit here and... Yeah, but...
All right, I'm going to toss everything back in the ring.
Everything's back in the ring?
Run! Run! Ah, what the fuck
happened? Turn off your shield there.
What the fuck happened? I'm gonna run past you.
It keeps
going back up there. Alright, let me run there first. That's 40. God damn it. How's it doing that?
It's doing the same thing to you that it did to me.
Apparently help you. That's 40, and I assume you want to move to the circle, right?
Yes.
Which is possible?
Yes.
Like that?
Yeah, that's good.
Okay.
All right.
Of course, you're leaning forward to indicate that you're running.
Speed walking.
Ninja run.
Ninja run. Dig. If you look around you, if you look beneath you, you will see several lights following you. Once more, they are exactly in the number of your comrades minus two. So you assume you may very well assume that they are your friends. Unfortunately, without some way of actually determining this for sure, you're not sure what they are. You're traveling several hundreds of floors up. It's an incredibly fast thing. You're still traveling.
Zig, you're being followed by ghosts. They're going to kill you.
In fact, that's what every single one of you is actually going to get. So, if you want to, you can just end your turns, unless you have something you can do that is able to be done while you're traveling at high speed on the ethereal plane.
Can I heal myself?
No, you cannot.
Then I'm going to end my turn.
I just ordinary down the pathway. Had to go follow.
Asshole.
Oh god, it's ghost!
What are you doing? Don't do that.
He's casting fireball down the back down towards us.
I cast doom scare.
Terrible. Then you're going to explode the teleporter, and it's going to cause another black hole, and then you're going to be two men down. Alright.
And you're not gonna have a cap.
Elia, I assume, is ending her turn?
Yeah, she probably couldn't identify either one of those things while going through there, huh?
No.
I didn't think so.
Basically, unless you can do an action that is, can be done while going on the ethereal plane, specifically in this case. If you're trying to do knowledge checks, fine. If you're trying to do something that doesn't require much effort, fine. But if you're doing anything that requires actual concentration or requires you to actually move or do anything like that, no.
I can just make it.
Basically, free actions, swift actions. All right. James and Deslo both clamber through the doorway, you know, both sprinting for their lives. James is up overtaking Deslo very easily. He's clearly more nimble, you know. And then he goes, armbar. No, I'm joking. That's not what happens. He disappears into things.
James jumps up onto the circle and says, "See ya. See ya on the other side, fucker." And disappears.
Yeah, what a dick.
He is.
All right. And we'll just go ahead and skip over to Deslo's turn, unless Steve or Lumu have any objections. Steve does not. Lumu?
Nope.
All right. Just for the record, Deslo, you hear one last snapping shut of the panel outside and the mechanism worrying about.
I wonder what that's all about. I'm just kidding.
Almost as if it's taunting you guys.
All right. I'm going to, yeah. All right. Put everything back on from my ring. Morphin time. And then head in to the thing.
Also, James is going to take a piss while going up through the
thing. No!
That's horrible. Alright. So guys, this will be the end of tonight. Actually, I have one last thing. Deslo's the only person who has not rolled yet. Also, James. James and Deslo, please roll your spot checks.
Alright.
Deslo gets to the teleporting circle. It disappears.
That would suck.
Oh no!
My friends, I gotta take the stairs. I'll be there.
The rest of this pyramid.
I gotta take the stairs. I'll be there later.
Okay, let me look at everybody's spot checks here. Okay, all right. I see who has made it here. Okay, so as you guys are going up, you know, zoom, 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 you're flying past these things. Zig, you're the first person to start noticing some different architecture as you go there. You start noticing that instead of going through actual floors, you actually start ending up in an area that looks like a very, very colossal spiraling staircase. You guys are flying right up the middle of it, you know, beyond all the railings of each individual staircase. The stairs actually kind of go in a square formation where there is a stairway that goes up and ends up in a flat area, another staircase that goes up and ends up in another flat area, and so on and so forth. Making it to where a lot of the flat areas are basically balconies. You guys keep moving past it and everything like that, on and on and on. Lumu and Deslo, you two are the only ones who actually notice something as you're going past these. For Lumu and Deslo, it takes several minutes. Several minutes. You are both going. Lumu and Deslo, as you fly past this, you notice something interesting. There appears to be two people walking along one of the rails. In fact, one of them is kind of perched up on, just kind of watching you guys fly by. The two of you need to roll one further spot check for me.
Okay. You should wave.
Lumu and Deslo. All right, both of you made it. This person, someone both of you have seen before. It's the red-headed Temptress, and she's sitting there smiling, watching you. And beside her is the Dragonkin, clad in black armor.
Like I said, you should wave.
Guys pass by, keep flying upwards.
We took the easy way.
Or could it be they were just waiting on you? It's only several seconds afterwards that you guys actually end up in your destination. You will not see tonight.
Blah, blah, blah. All right.
It's partly because the map is not done and it is almost 2 a.m.
That was exciting.
All right. Well, it actually is 2:08 for me.
Oh man. 2:48.
Yeah, man. Mm-hmm. I'm falling a hole. All right, guys. So that happened.
What demon did you sign a pact to avoid falling in that hole?
You'll find out soon enough.
It was Pipor. We all know this.
Okay. He's been a demon all along. That'd be a crazy twist of fate.
I'm going to kill Demon Spinos and Hellion, absorb their power, and become God.
Neither of them are the level of God, but they'd still be pretty powerful. But I was going to say, like, okay. Yeah, well, to fair, Quibor's ancestor was either raped or had consensual sex with a water genie of some sort, so... There you go.
Alright.
This is what I'm going to do. I'm going to get Duosphanos and Hellion, absorb their power, and then I'm going to absorb Lumo, And then I'm going to absorb some god.
Grapple check.
I cast darkness.
Oh shit, your reign of terror has just ended before it started. They may grapple you so hard that your neck gets twisted in the middle of the confusion, you die.
Alright, since that obviously said the GM said that's just allowed, make sure you do that when you fight Demon Spawners in Hellion there, Diablo.
At least you can grab fire, so.
Hellion are clearly better combatants than you are. Yeah.
That's why I'm absorbing their powers, so I can become a better combatant.
You actually gotta hand out the Desolate, that's true. I guess technically you couldn't grab water either. Like, just fall into a puddle.
Plus, Wybor would natural 20, and Lumu would natural 1.
Yeah, like we had our staring contest.
All of a sudden, I'm grappling you, Diablo.
Wybor would natural 20, and Lumu would still beat him in a grapple check.
Even with a natural 1?
Probably, actually.
Probably. But what if she had already absorbed Dumastanos and... what's his name?
Then she'd be even stronger. And he'd really not have a chance.
This is an actual course of action that y'all can do. I'm gonna absorb...
because this shit is... hell are you, old Majin Buu or some shit? This is what happens.
Okay. So yeah. What do you think is gonna happen next DM, guys?
What's happening? Pretty close.
Oh god. Lou would have one more point over me if I got a 20 and she rolled a 1.
There you go.
Now wait, am I raging? Because if I'm raging, it'd be like another 3 points.
I'm assuming this is going to be like a surprise meeting you around.
Well, this is going to be that picture of the person being like, you know, I used to be an adventurer like you, but I took an arrow in the knee. It's just like,
oh no, squeezes you. I got out intimidated. Wait, no, straight eyes modifier. I still beat you.
No.
Actually, I don't know how much
watching
the size matters.
Transformation sequence is pretty crazy.
In that case, I'm going to
yeah!
jump to safety. Oh.
Like Neely tries to intimidate y'all both, and she just starts like trying to tickle you or something.
Is it working? No. I have armor on. You can't really tickle me. those are good times. Good times. All right, I guess I will.